Okay, welcome to it. In this video, I want to show you how to make your own Faraday bag, your EMP bag, whatever you want to call it. And I want to show you the materials that you'll need. Now, inside this bag, I'll go ahead and open it for you. I have a set of walkie-talkies. And they're in a plastic bag. Now, the material that you use to create a Faraday bag, the material that I used is this here. It's called RF shielding. And I separated part of it so you can see. You have a metallic surface here. And then you have this woven, like, plastic mesh. I believe that's just to give it some strength and durability. And on the other side, you have the same material, the metallic foil. And so I cut up a piece big enough to wrap up these walkie-talkies and slide them in the bag. Now you also need metallic tape, duct. This is duct tape, not the plasticky cheap stuff. This is actual metallic tape with an adhesive on it. A good way to test it, if you get some RF shielding, is make the bag, put your cell phone in it, seal it with the tape. I want to make sure that all of the corners are sealed, and then give that phone a call. If it rings, you know it's not working. Now, another thing that you want to do is you want to make sure that you put your electronic device in a plastic bag. This insulates it from any kind of static electric or any kind of interference that may pass through. Now, if you built a Faraday cage or Faraday box out of this material, you could just simply ground it. But given that this is a bag and I don't know where I'm going to permanently store it, this is my insulator. So anyway, the reason why I decided to do walkie-talkies in this bag is, I think, should be obvious. If an EMP goes off, the likelihood of a cell tower and cell phone working is very slim. And so you want to be able to communicate with people. Now, I have a solar-powered battery charger. It charges AA batteries, and then I have a store of rechargeable batteries. Now, if you don't know what an EMP is, it may help to get educated. So I have a link in the video. And also, I have another link to give you some pointers on how to prepare for an EMP. So, there are some new things coming out about how prepared Americans are with EMPs. And American technology is actually being ruggedized, but older technology or very fine electronics, small circuits, are still vulnerable. So it is worth it in my mind to just have a few things stored away in a Faraday bag or an EMP bag. Anyway, thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions.